Hey guys, we are just outside of Tuscumbia, Alabama today. One of the most unique dining experiences you're gonna find. This is the Rattlesnake Saloon. Okay, so when you get to the Rattlesnake Saloon, it looks like you sit here and wait for a taxi to come get you and carry you down there. Now, this is our first time here, so this is a new experience for us. And yep, it looks like this is the taxi right here. This is also known as the Seven Springs Lodge. There are hiking trails and forest trails, and honestly, I'm not real sure what all is here, but it looks like there must be a lot here because there are a bunch of vehicles here. I will put a link to the website in the description, and you can check it out if you want. Now this is the little road that goes down to the saloon. It's our first time here, so first time seeing this. Kind of cool though. Okay, here we are. Is this cool or what? It's built into a cave. How cool is that? We're gonna get seated here. We'll take a look at the menu. Okay, take a look at the menu here. I'm not gonna read all this. I'm pretty sure most of y'all can read. First thing catches my eye though is this Rustler burger. I think I'll have that. Tara is probably going to have the Dilla, which is a steak and cheese and chicken quesadilla. Now, I also want to point out this Gigantor, which is a 2-pound burger. If you finish that in 45 minutes, it is free. And here we are sitting in a cave waiting for our food. And there's the saloon right there. Now, this is lunchtime. They don't serve alcohol at lunch. Which neither of us drink anyway, so but we'll probably still walk in there and check it out later. Okay, food's here. Tara got the Dilly, which is a cheese and chicken and steak quesadilla. And I did get the Rustler burger. I'm more of a plain burger kind of guy. Just pickles and ketchup most of all. I sometimes mustard, but we'll tell you about it once we get done with them. Okay, we finished eating, so we're going to take a look around here. They have a little stage back here. They have karaoke some nights. They also have live bands and live performers some nights. I think it would be really fun to come see that one night. Now, let's tell you about our food. Okay, I had the Rustler burger, and I got to tell you, it was the best burger I think that I have ever sunk my teeth into. The seasoning was really good. It was done perfect. Bun was good, fries were good, just a good experience. Tara had the Dilla, which is a chicken, steak, and cheese quesadilla. And she was really happy with that. Cooked to perfection, very good, good food. So we're just gonna take a look around here and just take this place in. All right, let's check out this saloon. Now, we didn't come prepared for any saloon brawls or shootouts, so I'm trying to start anything. Oh, nobody in here. That's right, they don't serve alcohol until 5 p.m., so it's not even close to 5 p.m. yet. I'm just gonna take a look around for a minute. if you're interested, the website tells all about the history of the land, history of the family, and the history of the saloon and the restaurant as well. So you can check that out if you want to. It will be in the description. Okay, one last shot, and I think we are fixing to head back up. We're going to take a quick stop at the gift shop, too, on our way out to look around there. Looks like we got some hoodies and some t-shirts, some tumblers up there. We got some CDs here for sale. I assume probably some of the folks that perform out in the saloon. And from here, you can actually take the stairs down to the saloon. So we're going to walk back here and take a quick look. These over here on the right, I think these are rental cabins. I'm not entirely sure. But that's what they look like to me. Okay, appreciate y'all coming along with us. We are now about to head to Rural King, about 20 miles up the road, and get some chicken feed, see what else we need there. So appreciate y'all watching, and we will see you next time.